JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 10th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It lost the most ground versus CHF, SEC and JPY, while it gained some ground only versus the Canadian dollar. The weakening of the US dollar may have been the result of the retreat in US Treasury yields, which means that stocks may have rebounded. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the tech-heavy Nasdaq gaining 3.69%, recording its best day since November 4th. Sentiment was more mixed today during the Asian session. Japan's Nikkei 225 and Hong Kong's Hang Seng gained 0.03 and 0.23% respectively, but China's Shanghai Composite and South Korea's KOSPI slid 0.05 and 0.60%. The recent rally in bond yields has hurt tech stocks the most due to their high valuations. High growth tech companies are valued based on earnings expected years into the future, and thus when yields rise, their discounted present value declines. The opposite is true when yields retreat. That's why Nasdaq was the main gainer yesterday. As for today, bearing in mind that the latest surge in bond yields was attributed to fears over high inflation in the not-too-distant future, a 10-year Treasury auction and the US CPIs for February may attract special attention. The headline CPI rate is forecast to have risen to 1.7% year-over-year from 1.4%, while the core one is anticipated to have held steady at 1.4%. In our view, rising headline inflation may add to concerns over high inflation and thereby push yields higher. As a result, the US dollar could strengthen and equities could resume their slide. Having said all that, though, we stick to our guns that the latest decline in equities and any short-term extensions of it may be a corrective phase. The Fed has clearly noted that any spike in inflation in the months to come will be temporary and that it will rise and stay above 2% for some time in the years after 2023. As a result, we believe that inflation fears will subside in the foreseeable future, which may allow equities and other risk-linked assets to perform well. Now, apart from the US CPIs and any movements in bond yields, market participants may also pay attention to the Bank of Canada monetary policy decision. At its prior meeting, the Bank of Canada decided to keep interest rates and the pace of its QE purchases unchanged, disappointing those expecting a small cut or even a re-increase in quantitative easing. Officials also noted that as the Governing Council gains confidence in the strength of the recovery, the pace of net purchases of Government of Canada bonds will be adjusted as required, which suggests that the next policy step for the Bank of Canada may be tapering quantitative easing. However, the employment report for January disappointed, with the unemployment rate rising to 9.4% from 8.9%, and the net change in employment showing that the economy has lost 212,800 jobs. What's more, although the CPIs for January came in better than expected, they still stayed below the Bank of Canada's inflation aim of 2%, while last week, GDP data showed that the Canadian economy has slowed more than anticipated in December. Thus, with that in mind, we don't believe that tapering may be on the cards for the months to come. We expect Bank of Canada officials to sound more dovish this time around, diminishing expectations on that front, something that could hurt the Canadian dollar. That said, we expect any retreat in the loonie to be temporary. Oil prices have surged after the decision from OPEC and its allies to not to increase output. And although they pulled back this week, they stayed in uptrend mode. What's more, as we already noted, we expect equities to rebound soon, something that may keep the commodity-linked loonie supported as well. Now, as for the rest of today's events, apart from the US CPIs and the Bank of Canada monetary policy decision, we have the Energy Information Administration report on crude oil inventories for last week. Expectations are for a 0.816 million barrels per day inventory build after the 21.563 million surge the week before. That said, bearing in mind that the American Petroleum Institute reported a 12.792 million barrels per day build, we would consider the risks to the Energy Information Administration print as tilted to the upside. A positive surprise may allow oil prices to continue correcting lower for a while more. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.